in terms of nuclear science and technology. Right, nuclear science and technology. Now, microwave. Long range will come there. Now, nuclear science and technology. First thing, what you have to know is from nuclear reactor technology. Right, nuclear reactor technology. There, and particularly from India's nuclear program. I'll just go into that. You have to connect with the India's three stages nuclear power program there. Last year, the question which was asked was not directly from science and technology linked with nuclear technology. The question was asked about from the nuclear suppliers group waiver to India in terms of the kind of agreement where India can like use the fuel or some part of the nuclear reactor for any kind of weapon program. So sometimes the question can be from IR perspective also. But from technology point of view, you should know that how the reactors are being used in India for atomic energy or nuclear power program. So we have a three stage nuclear power program and a main exam. The question is the mains exam has been asked on fast breeder reactor, FBR, which is the first time in India we have brought this technology where we can use uranium-238 into plutonium. The plutonium utilization part has been brought. Now, after that, what you need to work here is that you should know the nuclear science and technology application in agriculture, medical science, industry. So the various area where other application of nuclear science and technology comes, you should be aware of what type of development Bharat Atomic Research Center, Trombe, has developed the innovative products and technologies there. So any kind of such application, even there also UPSC can ask question. Let's say radioisotope technology, how we use radioisotope in nuclear medicine, how we use gamma radiation for food irradiation for food processing industry. So those kind of other applications. One is that power generation, where we use for power aspect of that, electricity and power generation. Second is in terms of other areas of application. So you have to see from the three perspectives. Now let's look at here. I'll do one thing here. I'll go through the concept, but again I'll connect here. Here, always remember that DAE, Department of Atomic Energy, has all entire work in the field of nuclear power and nuclear science and technology. Now here, DAE's achievement. You have to always make sure that last 4-5 years achievements, right? That their UPSC can. This is first what I'm now opening here. This is the 4 years of eventful for that. It gives you the highlight. What in the last 4 years, Government of India, Department of Atomic Energy has achieved. So just in front of you, I've done the Google search so that when you yourself search, you'll get that. So now let's understand here. See, when you come to the nuclear reactor technology, just few basic things here. Any nuclear reactor, you have the four major components on which it works. The first is called here fuel. Okay, what is the fuel here? Now fuel is kept in terms of fuel rods. And that is put in the core of the reactor. The central part of the core, where you have an assembly of fuel rods like 50, 100, 200. That depends on the how much power is generated by the reactor. And that will vary from types of reactors. Different types of reactors will be there. Now fuel can be either, it can be a mixture of uranium-235. Uranium has got atomic number 92, there's number of electrons equal to number of protons, and the mass number is 235. The natural uranium consists of two types of isotope, 235 and 238. It's a uranium-235 which undergoes fission when bombarded by slow neutron. So most of the reactors worldwide, they work with the help of uranium-235 and uranium-238 as a fuel. For power generation, we require generally low enriched uranium. That means the percentage should not be 100%. For power generation, we require hardly 3-5%. Where we require high enriched uranium? For weapon program. Let's say when we have to make atom bomb or nuclear weapon, there we require high level of enrichment of 235. Here with the low enrichment, 5%, that is sufficient to go for power generation. But sometimes the fuel can be here, where we can use uranium-238 and plutonium-239 as a oxide, or sometime thorium. Thorium-232 can be used as a fuel. That depends on the design of the reactor, for what purpose the reactor has been designed. Now, another important thing for any reactor is to control the reactor. That is the most important part. You take any kind of reactor working with uranium as a fuel, plutonium as a fuel, or thorium as a fuel. The next very important part comes, the controller element. Now, controller, right, is again in the form of rod, controller rod, which is inserted inside the core of the reactor, and that is made of boron, cadmium, and earlier there was use of graphite. The role of the controller rod is that it controls the number of neutrons which is required for the reaction. Like here, it absorbs, and through absorption of the neutron, that it acts in terms of the controlling the number of reactions in the core of the reactor, because the more the number of neutrons, more reaction. Less number of neutron, less reaction. And if you have to shut down the reactor, again controller can absorb all neutrons. So that neutron efficiency or numbers, that is done through controller rods. What they are made of? Boron. Boron is one, cadmium or such kind of graphite. Third very important component of a reactor is moderator. Moderator is another very important component of a reactor, which is basically control the energy of the neutron. Right? This is where also control comes, but actually here slow down. It slows down thermal neutron or a fast neutron. Because only the slow neutron will be captured by uranium-235, which will become unstable and then undergo disintegration. So first you have to bring down the energy of the neutrons, and that is done through moderator. One of the preferred material, which you know, that deuterium oxide or heavy water. Heavy water used as a, because heavy water is slightly heavier in terms of mass number, slightly heavier than normal light water, and is able to retard or slow down the fast neutrons. But moderation can be done with normal water also. It's not that moderator is always a heavy water. There are some type of advanced reactor which can control the speed of the neutron by temperature and pressure. Normal water can also be used. But generally, what is preferred? Heavy water, that one. And what comes the next one, the important one is the coolant. Heavy water is a deuterium oxide, is a chemically it is a water only. But only the difference is that instead of hydrogen, it has a deuterium, the heavier form of isotope of hydrogen, slightly heavier than the normal water. And why we prefer? There is a type of which can slow down the neutron. That's where the heavy water comes. They represent deuterium oxide. Now another thing, coolant. The coolant, they keep the temperature of the core at constant. Here, to keep temperature of core constant. Or what I can write here, another role is that absorb the heat from the core of the reactor and make steam which will run the turbine, which can go for power generation. So here, absorption of heat, because ultimately you need a working substance. So what is working substance? Steam. The steam will run the turbine, mechanical to electrical. So that is what done through coolant. Now coolant can be normal water, or coolant can be sometimes heavy water. That depends on where we want to use as a coolant, what type of material we want to use. See, that's what this is a basic thing. When you look into any reactor design, this is the first thing which you have to know. Okay, what exactly is the reactor there? UPSC is not going to ask you engineering design, the internal design of the reactor, that is not the important. But what are the key components one should be aware of, and what is the role of it? What type of materials are used? That is the important thing. Now what I want to bring here, if you see here, this handout, what I've just opened here, and I'll just take you to part of this one. I'm sorry. Is this wire problem there? Anyway, sorry. Now see here, what is it? I'll just come to the part, this one. What are the report says here? Transformational boost to nuclear energy. 10 indigenous reactor. That what we have developed a technology in India, not from the foreign reactors in the country. Then you find here Kudankulam, two reactors from Kudankulam, that is from Russia, from Russian reactor. Then here, Indo-Russia friendship and cooperation, 100% power in Jan 2017. Unit 3 and 4 in Kudankulam nuclear power park of each of 1000 megawatt. Our reactors are 700 megawatt. Russian reactor can generate more power, that's 1000 megawatt. This is what is mentioned that. So when you go further in the report here, see what is said here, 22 nuclear reactor operational. Right now, presently we have 22 reactors which are operational. And that is generating 6780 megawatt. So if we take total basket of energy, nuclear power contributes only 3 to 4%. Not much, maximum 69%. You can say power generated thermal based power plant, coal and gas based. Nuclear is again just a small one. Though we have an ambitious plan to expand the nuclear power, but still today it contributes very less. Right, now let's understand what I've kept here. This operational reactor is there. Now let's understand here. I'll just do one thing here. I'll make a flow chart here, very important flow chart. And I think this can be even asked in the prelims exam as well there. See, if you take a nuclear program of India, so in India's, you can draw this flow chart here. India's are three stages. There's a nuclear power program. You'll be able to understand the logic here, how the things have been now designed and how India is operating there. So what type of reactors, what type of technology India is using there. In this three-stage nuclear power program, our first stage, stage one, our stage one, that is a in type of reactor, what is called PHWR. India has developed pressurized heavy water reactor. This is the indigenous one. What do you have in the report, Kudankulam from Russia, that is a not heavy water based, that is a normal light water based. But what India has got, the heavy water here, PHWR. Now this PHWR, you understand this one. Here, the fuel what it burns is a mixture of uranium-235 and uranium-238. Now what happens, this gets fission. It breaks. When we use a rod with 235, 238, 235 will be used up. Right? The uranium-238, a small part of it converts into plutonium. Only small part. Why it becomes there? Because in the reaction there will be some fast neutron, and that fast neutron can convert few amount of 238 into plutonium. What is called transmutation. Now what is the thing here? Second type of stage two, what India has now gone into the second stage, we have developed a very important reactor called fast breeder reactor. Now breeder reactor is the reactor which breed or generate, right? It first breed or generate a material for fission from non-fissional material like uranium-238 naturally does not undergo fission with slow neutron. So what is done here, uranium-238 with the help of fast neutron. Here we don't slow down the neutron. We allow the fast neutron to pass through the fuel and that get converted into plutonium. So from where we'll get this? The byproduct of the first stage will become the part of the fuel of the second stage. What we can do after the reaction is over in first stage, we can process. We can do the processing of the fuel and take the uranium-238 plutonium and use it in the second stage. That's called economy. We want to be more efficient in using the fuel. We don't want to waste the fuel. Right? So this will go into second stage. After processing of the fuel, we can put in second stage. And what undergoes fission here? Which one? The main is uranium-238, the same 238. We can take the 238. And whatever small amount is, both can be used up here.
Both
can be used. Uranium-238 will extract there. And this uranium-238 will go into the second stage. So we can directly use also there. Now another thing, very important.
Why will we use that uranium-238 in first stage?
No, because actually the thing is that we cannot use 100% uranium-235. We have to mix uranium-235 with 238. So let's say 5% 235, 95% 238. Another thing is that when we do the mining of the ore, so which is more abundant? 238 is more abundant. 235 is very less in the nature also. So that always is always used in a mixed form. It's not always in pure form. Now what is very important, see here. Plutonium 239 will undergo fission here. And can we use that? Now another thing, very important thing. Thorium. We can also convert thorium into uranium 233. Now uranium 233 is not naturally available. What is naturally available? 235 and 238. What we can do in fast breeder reactor? We can convert thorium 232 into uranium 233. Now why it has been done? The logic is that thorium itself is non-fissile. It's not that you take thorium and pass neutron, it will undergo fission. No. Thorium becomes fissile only when mixed with uranium. You have to first mix with uranium. Then only thorium will undergo fission. Directly you cannot use thorium. So what we can do in fast breeder reactor program? Convert the thorium into uranium 235 or uranium 233 and then use in third stage. Our third stage, which comes here, the third stage of the power program, what India is now developing right now, we have not so far started the third stage. India has limited uranium but abundant thorium. We have got abundant thorium in terms of monazite sands in the Kerala. We have Kollam. Kollam is one place where we have a huge deposit of the monazite. Even some part of Tamil Nadu and Orisha also there. So what is the third stage what India has planned for this is that we will be using a very important type of reactor, and the prototype has been developed, advanced heavy water reactor. Advanced heavy water reactor, this AHWR, and this AHWR, here the fuel is either thorium 232 mixed with uranium 233, or we can use as a fuel thorium with plutonium. What I've said that thorium itself is non-fissile. We cannot directly use thorium unless until we mix thorium with uranium or plutonium. Now comes the question, from where we'll get plutonium? FBR. Or from where we get U-233? Again? FBR. So here, this can be fed. This can become as a part of here. Either we can use the plutonium for power generation or extract, reprocess the plutonium and use in third stage. That is called, see what I've said, either we can convert 238 into plutonium and again undergo fission and the power generation, or processes. We can reprocess it and use it in the third stage. Or convert thorium to 233, to extract that and use it as a fuel. So that will feed the third stage. So what is very important? Our three-stage nuclear power program and the reactor technologies are integrated. One stage will be fed into second stage. That's what we have designed there. That means one stage byproduct is the fuel for another stage. This is what the program is there. So that, let's say in future, we'll have 100% use of uranium and thorium. All the use will be there. Right? So this is what the reactor technology has been worked out. Now what comes here? Now you may ask which is moderator, which is coolant. Was the fuel part I have explained. This is the fuel part. Now here, which is the moderator here? Precise heavy water reactor. In this case, we use moderator as a deuterium oxide. Heavy water is used as a moderator, and also coolant is also heavy water. Heavy water has two roles in the first type of reactor. It is used both as a coolant and moderator. Now second stage here, we don't use moderator because we are using fast neutron. It only uses a coolant liquid sodium. Liquefied sodium that is used as a coolant here. Because we don't have to slow down the neutron. We require neutron, and again remember that. Plutonium can undergo fission with fast neutron. We don't have to use a slow neutron. Plutonium ko fission karne ke liye fast neutron chahiye. So fast neutron se humne kya kiya, 238 ko convert kiya plutonium mein. Aur usi fast neutron se kya ko, plutonium will undergo fission. It's a fast neutron reactor. Sometimes they are called fast neutron reactor. So there we don't require moderator. We require coolant to extract the heat and then use it for another purpose. And in this case here, ASWR. ASWR is here, we use here moderator. Here the moderator is used as a heavy water, deuterium oxide, but the coolant, which is converted to steam, that is the normal water. In this case, the normal water becomes the steam. But the moderation is done through heavy water. This is what the system we have.
In this 100 states, it is basically endless thorium, because 100% efficiency converter is not there. Thorium is only there mainly because of what is not
converted. Converted, that's only being made. Only for to assisting that, we are adding plutonium and uranium. Ultimately, this is a thorium reactor. Ultimately, what is the fuel here? Thorium. Only to assist thorium to undergo fission, we are using mixing with uranium and plutonium. But ultimately, it is a thorium. Now, what is the status of India's thorium? Where India stands in thorium? We have got the highest deposit in the world. But though production-wise, we are not top ranking. We have a deposit. 25% of thorium in the world is in India. But in terms of producing there, Turkey, USA, those countries are the top ranking which produce and sell in the market. India has a deposit. So we are trying to develop the system there. In future, we can have that. Now, if you see here, further, I'll just take you to the main part. See what is mentioned here. When you go to this document here, it says that Indian Nuclear Insurance Pool. Now, what is here called civil nuclear liability? What is civil nuclear liability? If, let's in future, if there is any kind of accident, so that insurance pool has been made. So that is the damage or compensation can be given from this 1,500 crore rupees. This is what the government has, IEA International, that's the agency for energy, this atomic energy agency, Vienna based Austria, we have signed this convention. And now India has ratified the convention. International Atomic Energy Agency, that's the convention has been there. Now if you see here, what is given here? Radioactive waste management plan.
Operator.
Yes, that's what the Dr. Manmohan Singh government. At that time, there were a lot of controversy that India has diluted the stand because of pressure of the USA. So now who is the liable? The operator. And who is the operator? Department of Energy. We are the operator. Like you know the name of the company, NPCIL, which is headquartered in Mumbai, is operating all the nuclear reactors. So if tomorrow, let's say any accident takes place, any damage, then the NPCIL has to pay for it. Any such thing happens in future. So what was the, at that time, controversy? That we should have held even liability to the supplier who was supplying the reactor, let's say Russia or France, right? But then those foreign suppliers wanted to safeguard themselves. Okay, so that they are not at question mark in future if any accident takes place. Right? Even the Jetapur, a lot of controversies happened. Jetapur in Maharashtra, initially we had a sign with Areva, but then Areva back out. Now we are having with EDP, another company, we are having their sign. So though the land has been acquired, but still it is in the progress there. What we find here, that all those kind of reactors what we are having right now, 22 reactors, is all in the old park. So where we have the parks there? If you see the nuclear parks in India, so one is Trombay, and second in Tarapur. So both of these are in Maharashtra. We have a nuclear park right from the beginning, Bark, Bhabha Atomic Research Center. The other one is Kudankulam in Tamil Nadu. And there's another one near Chennai, that's Kalpakkam. See, Kalpakkam is near to Chennai, but Kudankulam is down south Madurai. When we go to Rameswaram side, coastal side, we have Kudankulam. So both of these are from the Tamil Nadu. So these are two parks we have. Then you'll find Kakrapar, that is in part of Gujarat there. Right, then Kaiga is in the Karnataka. We have a nuclear park there. Then Rawat Bhata in Rajasthan. So Rawat Bhata, that is in Rajasthan, we are having this nuclear park. Then comes here, important one, UP, Bulandshahr Narora. Narora Atomic Power Station, that is in UP. These are the existing nuclear parks. Jetapur and all is the future, where we are building that. But this is where we have 22 reactors working there. So what happens, the old reactors are decommissioned, new reactors are built on that part. Unit 3, Unit 4, whatever numbers are there. Our today nuclear reactors are not that efficient. India has been predominantly first stage. Now we are getting to second stage. Now our second stage program, I'll just add here, this has been developed by a center called IGCR, Indira Gandhi Center for Atomic Research, Kalpakkam. Our second stage is not in Trombay, not in Tarapur, not in that, is there in Kalpakkam in Tamil Nadu, where the second stage fast breeder reactor technology has been brought. and which can generate 500 megawatt the electricity, electric power, 500 megawatt. That they developed in the Kalpakkam Indira Gandhi Center for Atomic Research. That's we have developed. You will find here, see what is given, India's largest radioactive waste management plant in at Kalpakkam to take care of the nuclear waste which is generated after the reaction. For that, Kalpakkam, there is a waste management plant has been there. Now see here, this is part I wanted to make. This is prototype fast breeder reactor undergoing commissioning. First criticality of 500 megawatt reactor Kalpakkam 2018. We have gone into that. So that's why today we are in second stage. Future will be the thorium reactor. That's going to be future. We are still working on the technology part. But the two part we have started. Right? So let's say if you get a direct question, simple question in the exam, so then you have to connect with this. So here we have PSWR, how much power it can generate? 700 megawatt. That's a part of. Here this can be 500 megawatt. And what we have developed a prototype by Bark. They are developed by Bark here. Bhabha Atomic Research Center in Trombay, Bark has developed a thorium reactor. It's a 300 megawatt reactor. Just a prototype has been developed, 300 megawatt. Right? Russian and France are more advanced, they generate more power. So here you have this second stage mentioned. Now see fuel record, say nuclear fuel production, world record production of fuel for a reactor. Again, that number is not important. How much is the number? That is not important. But say that we have produced high amount of this. Now comes your isotope production.
Sir, is there any relation with the power and the stage that we are using?
Power and the stage? No, just in terms of reactor technology.
And then why do we favor stage 3 just because we have a lot of thorium?
That's only the one.
More efficient than
No, because of more thorium. Where we are favoring stage 3, to utilize thorium in India.
That's it.
That's the main part of that. No. See, if the power generation is 300 megawatt.
Yes.
It's very less. If you compare this to, it's lesser there, 300 megawatt. It's only for thorium utilization. We are going for that. Yes, thorium will be cost effective in Indian cost because of the abundance. That's cost effective. Because today, uranium we have to import from outside. Today, let's say, first stage, water power generation, we have to get the enriched uranium from outside. We have to buy from outside, Russia, Mongolia, Kazakhstan, and we have to pay money for that. But here, let's say, initially, technology will be costly for thorium reactor. But once we develop it, it will be cheaper. Because we can have mass production, and we can generate more power. That is the uranium presence in India is limited, but thorium is abundant. So slowly, we are gradually going to that direction. Today it is very costly because all 22 reactors what we have present today require uranium continuously. And our production of uranium is not that continuous. So whenever we buy a reactor from Russia, we make in the deal that as long as the reactor is working, Russia will keep on providing us fuel. But Russia will not do it free, we have to pay price to them. So that they earn the money from us in terms of providing the fuel. Right? So that's what India is now looking for future thorium reactor. Though the progress has been slow, but still we have developed the technology. Technology has been developed. It only requires commercialization. Right? So, the now here, I am telling you a very important part of this year's exam. Two reactors you have to remember, which is very important for this year's exam. One is a reactor. The Dhruva reactor for at bar for medical isotope production. And the other one, I will show you the required, report also, that is called Apsara. One Apsara was earlier which we decommissioned. Now we have got last year a new Apsara reactor commissioned in Trombay. It's one of the very important achievement from Department of Atomic Energy. This Dhruv reactor which is used for cobalt 60 for cancer treatment, cancer like Tata Memorial Hospital in Mumbai, the cancer hospital, you know, the people come from all over India for treatment of cancer. They use such kind of isotope. And today it is supplied by Navi Mumbai, there is a center of DAE that supply all the medical isotope. And today India is a leading producer of medical isotope. Not only for our own purpose, we export, we sell it outside also. So that is done by Bark Center. Bark has a center which make the isotope. And this reactor called Dhruv reactor, this is the highest capacity in 2016-17. Right? This is separately for research purpose and the radioisotope generation. So such areas which are given such report becomes important for exam. Now Apsara part, let me just tell you.
So what's a nuclear medicine, sir?
I'll come to that. I'll be coming to that. Nuclear medicine. Just a small thing. What is a? I'm just minimizing this one. Let me go on there. A very important part, which I'm opening in front of you only. Year-end review. In PIB, you'll find DAE review. There's a 2018 there. There's one. Atomic energy, 2018. Ab isme ye cheez hai. This report, I'm opening this one. And you can see here, this Kaiga and all is not important. This is important. Apsara. I'll just zoom out here. This has come in the current affairs material also there, you'll find that. Apsara is a upgraded swimming pool type reactor. September 2018. It was earlier decommissioned, it was an old Apsara, the new has been brought. The reactor is designed to produce a variety of isotope and serve as nuclear physicist, material scientist, reactor designers, state of the art facility. The one is Dhruv is making the isotope, and second now we have started with another Apsara.
So it's an R&D reactor?
R&D reactor, research reactor. And at the same time the isotope production. Radioisotope can be, see here, nuclear physicist, material scientist and reactor designers to provide state-of-the-art facilities. This is what has been given here. And it was there in the PIB separate, you will find PIB there, separate link you will find about Apsara, right? Now coming to this part, what I'll do here, let's clean this part. What he has asked, nuclear medicine part. Now the nuclear medicine, we can understand from 3-4 perspective. When you use in healthcare part, the first is that the first part which comes here, the use of devices like here, scanning machine. To locate, let's say, tumor, any kind of tumor or cancer cell, or let's say any kind of problem in the inside human body. Like for example, one type of instrument called PET. Right, PET scanning is there, it stands for positron emission tomography. Second, when you say nuclear medicine, that deals with the radio tracer element. They generate radiation, like gamma rays there, and we can trace any kind of abnormality in the body. Like let's say here, I'll give you an example, there's a sodium 24. It's used for heart and cardiac problem there. Then let's say iodine 131, they are used for thyroid. Study of thyroid. So sometimes doctors can use such isotope which can trace any kind of problem in the heart or any body organs, even a brain also can be studied there. And third comes here, what? Nuclear medicine or drug. This medicine, let's say, which is used by isotope, like for example, cobalt 60, used in radiotherapy, used in radiation therapy for killing of cancer cell, the therapy is being used by the doctors in the cancer hospital for therapy part. This can deliver the amount of gamma radiation to kill the tumor and cancer cell. So that is used for that. And if you remember there, I would have mentioned in the mains class also there, there's one instrument called Bhabatron. There's a low cost indigenous machine, there's a cobalt 60 based radiotherapy machine is there, called teletherapy machine, which our scientists have developed. And today we have gifted this machine to other countries also for treatment of cancer. This has been developed through our own. And you'll find in this, if I take you to this part of here, I'll go back to that, you'll see that, I'll come back to other, but now look at here. 75 radioisotopes produced in various applications. 10 lakh plus patients are being benefited from radio immunoassay RIA, that is the antibody. Dhruv reactor is given here. Now another thing, India has first time develop cesium, cesium isotope from liquid nuclear waste for blood purification device, cesium. Now this is one achievement. First of its kind in the world, India is the only country to have this technology in commercial domain. For blood purification, cesium based, these are developed there. 7 blood irradiation have been like supplied to hospitals. Cancer hospitals have already got this technology, has been now supplied there. Then what do you find here, see here? Cancer grid, national cancer grid. 137 location in India are being joined, these all cancer hospitals being joined. And the places given here, Varanasi, Mohali, Sangrur in Punjab, Vishakhapatnam, all this medicine center in Kolkata. Now you can see here, human trial for radionuclide based drugs. This is given here, this arthritis. Arthritis, brain, this is all the name given. See. Technetium isotope, then is given imaging for heart, then for the processes. Like sometimes, you know, knee implant, the implant what we do. So we can have a scanning for that, whether it is working or not. Again, from the medicine part. And now this is a collaboration. LIGO, Laser Interference Gravitational Wave Observatory, and then IAEA. And then you have a partnership with the other countries, France, Japan, and Russia. And then what you find here, Bahadurgarh there in Delhi, near Delhi, Haryana, there's Global Center for Nuclear Energy Partnership. An academic university has been set up. And this Bhabhaton is here. Agreement and this Vinatom, Vietnam agreement. Then with Canada, the Bangladesh here. Another very important, Bangladesh. Trilateral agreement with Russia and India with Bangladesh for building Rukpur nuclear park. Now India is making the reactor there in Bangladesh for their nuclear power generation. Like as Russia built in India, now Russia and India together in Bangladesh. And the place is given Rukpur. There's a Rukpur nuclear power project in Bangladesh.
First,
you can say first time like where India, now you can say India has gone into nuclear commerce. Then we will be earning money from the neighborhood, neighboring country. So maybe next, sometime in future, like we can have in with Bhutan also there, with Myanmar also there, with Afghanistan also there, the nuclear power generation. The first example comes, Rukpur. And this you can see Bhabhaton this here. This is Bhabhaton. You can have this machine is there. We deliver the dose of the radiation, Mongolia, Kenya, Kyrgyzstan. We have given those to other countries. Same instrument, what is called Bhabhatron. So not only used in India, today we are using in Mumbai also this Bhabhatron, but also we have given to other countries. It's indigenous development. So that comes into nuclear, whenever say nuclear therapy and all, this is nuclear medicine comes into that. And today is India is leading producer of nuclear medicine. We are making a large amount of that. That's our achievement in the last 50 years in the field of science and technology. But nuclear technology, you'll find that. Now coming to here, this one, Astrosat. India's first astronomical satellite. And there's one very important institute just nearby here, TIFR. Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, Kulaba. It's a very big campus, you know that. Our program started from there only. This is south of Mumbai, TIFR campus. At that time, Trombay was not there. Trombay became later, our research started from there. TIFR is under DAE, Department of Atomic Energy. And today the Astrosat, India's astronomical satellite, built by ISRO, contains the telescope or instrument from TIFR, which is from Department of Atomic Energy. See, it's given here three of the five instruments, large area X-ray proportional counters, right, soft X-ray telescope, and cadmium zinc telluride imager. They have been developed by TIFR scientists. Right? It's India's first multi-wavelength astronomical satellite. It is also called sometime Hubble of India, because through Astrosat we are able to study the stars, neutron star, black hole, all this we are getting the information. And there is a telescope, you can see the telescope, soft X-ray telescope, X-ray, UV rays, visible light. It works with three wavelength, one is X-ray, second is ultraviolet rays, and third is visible light. It's getting all the data. So again, that is one of the achievement of DAE, which has been developed here. Now another one for BrahMos. What is BrahMos missile? BrahMos missile. One example is from ISRO satellite. But what is BrahMos missile? It's a cruise missile. Right, Russia and India together has built that. is a fastest supersonic cruise missile. Now see here, antenna has been made. Seeker. This is a radio antenna, radio telescope like radio antenna, can locate the path of BrahMos missile. And also can be used for PSLV. Deployed and used successfully for PSLV mission. For tracking this radar is there. This is called radio astronomy. Why the role of DAE comes? Radiation. Radio astronomy. Astronomy and radiation. Abhi recently bahut bada khoj hua hai. First time the image of black hole has been taken by 8 type of radio telescopes in the world. What is called Event Horizon Telescope. Event Horizon. There's again the ground-based telescope, which has zoomed to that particular M87, that is the name of galaxy, and then tried to take the photograph of supermassive black hole. So there's again radiation coming from outer space and developing that photograph. So we too have such kind of antenna. This is done by Indian scientists. We have been developing such kind of radio astronomy based system in India. Anything regarding astronomy plus radiation, radio astronomy, DAE is involved, Department of Atomic Energy. So you have this given here for BrahMos there. Now superconductivity. Scientists of TIFR, they work with pure bismuth. And the discovery challenged the 1972 Nobel Prize. 1972 Nobel Prize was given that high temperature superconductors. Now what our scientists have found, something new, which challenged the part of the that Nobel Prize which has come there. This is what given here. Now that may be us, may not be us, just a simple understanding part. Now this is important, water purification. This is our scientist, detection of chromium contamination and transfer for commercial production. Then now as per WHO standard. This has been developed by our scientist. Right. Now what I'll do here, this is what I've given nuclear medicine. Now just understand here. Another thing from nuclear science and technology which can be asked this year exam, and current affairs science tech materials have covered this area, that is called nuclear agriculture. How we use nuclear science and technology in the field of agriculture. So who will tell me the application part, which are part of it? One is that water purification technology. First thing is that, what I'm now writing here, use of selective mutation. What is mutation? Change in the gene or DNA of seeds by using radiation, by using low and high dose radiation technology. We can use some kind of selective mutation, some kind of targeted mutation, change in the gene of seeds by using low and high dose radiation to develop a high yield variety. High yield varieties of seeds. Let's say here, I'll give you example. One example is Trombe crop varieties. Scientists in Trombe have worked to develop, and one of the very important thing which are commercialized is groundnut. For example here, a variety of groundnut, which is now in the market. Like I'll give you example here, TAG, T-A-G, TAG 24. Trombe Akula, Akula in Maharashtra. You know the Akula place, there's the groundnut, Mungfali. That is a high yield variety of Mungfali, right, that has been developed through Bark Center. And today is already there in the market. So that is a first use is there. So what is very important? This one. We can bring about mutation by using the radiation. Radiation technology comes. Now what is second aspect? Second aspect comes here. That is in terms of food irradiation. A lot of time you'll find this irradiated food, and food irradiation has made a headlines. Now what is the advantage if you use irradiated food? Let's say food irradiation. What advantage can be there if we do this kind of irradiation of food by some gamma rays, X-ray, whatever may be that. So the benefits are, like one is that to increase the shelf life. That's a shelf life will be more there. So you can keep it for a long time. Second is that germicidal effect. It will kill all the germs there. Like as you know, the ultraviolet rays are used for killing germs, bacteria and all. Same thing can happen in food items. That will prevent what? Spoilage. Food will not be spoiled. Another example, to prevent sprouting. We can prevent sprouting in the tubers. Like, let's say, for example, potato or onion. This all can be prevented. Will not sprout. Again, we can keep for a long time. Right? It keeps the freshness. It is also, again, to maintain. Because it will not get spoiled easily, so we can maintain the freshness of the crop. And I'll give you one good example from this document only. There's a place in Bihar called Muzaffarpur. It's known for lychee. There it has been done. Now see here. Water purification, low cost, nano-composite ultrafiltration membrane, nanotechnology part of it, right? And I'll take you to this part. Now another see. Preparation of thin film based sea water reverse osmosis system developed. And now this is what? Lychee up to 60 days. Mention that. Developed technology to preserve lychee up to 60 days at low temperature while retaining its nutritional, sensory, functional and colored qualities. This one example is given here. But you can say mango, like now the summer the mangoes are there, and you know Alfonso, hapus, which is exported. Again the radiation technology. But now comes the question whether that will cause any health hazard. Let's say if you take in the market, such irradiated food is there and we consume. Let's say mango or let's say lychee or you take any example. Will that cause any kind of health impact, cancer or tumor? Because all these are radiation processed. So that is what certified here. The certification is done by FSSI. These are done in the control condition. Food safety and standard authority. It's all done under controlled conditions. It's not that they will have that kind of amount. If radiation remains there, that will be dangerous. Because once we eat, we get the radiation. So that's done in the control condition and certified by Food Safety Standard Authority of India. We have guidelines. This is what they have done there. Now another thing here, very unique example given. This one, mustard seed. One example I have given, groundnut. Now here mustard seed. Develop advanced varieties of mustard seed with higher yields and then national check varieties. Now that is called Rajasthan, it has got TM1081 pre-release in 2016. Another example, Dubraj rice, semi-dwarf variety of Dubraj rice with 35% higher yield, Chhattisgarh in May 2017. And what do you have in the photograph of the mustard? See, one is what crossbreeding, where we do the crossbreeding and make high yield varieties. Second, we can do GM variety, like GM mustard, genetically modified. So there what we do, we use the recombinant DNA technology, genetic engineering. And third is what? This gamma radiation, mutation part. So we can do manipulation anyway. Whichever scientists think can develop a new variety, can develop that. This is an example there, mustard seed. And let's say if a question comes in the exam, there may be a direct question asked. Right? Now what I'm coming here, this food part, which I mentioned, agriculture part, what are industrial application of nuclear technology? Industrial form. Like you have seen that nano composite, nano filter, any other application part? You all have written this one? This part is done there? This part is done? Right? Okay, now who will tell me? Industrial use of nuclear technology. Industrial use. Use in industry. Power is one there. Apart from the power? Defense is also there, right? Okay, then other than that, first thing comes here, Rolly camera. This scanner is there to detect crack. We can find out crack or any fault in metallic pipes. In metallic pipes or structures, and it becomes very important for those type of structure which has to be foolproof. Let's say aeroplane, the body of the aeroplane should be foolproof. It should not have a crack which can cause accident. Or let's say oil and gas pipeline, where we supply the gas and the oil, should be totally foolproof. This Rolly camera is there. You have seen this metro pillars or airport which we make the highways and all. Again, if there are cracks in that, so what happens slowly under the burden, the load, that crack can become bigger and can, you know, collapse. The bridge can collapse. So there's a method where we do the scanning of such kind of thing there. The nuclear technology is used in that case. Then what comes here, second thing is come here, flow measurement. There's a flow measurement of liquid and all, and that is done in the case of spectroscopy by spectrometer. I'll give you another very important, which you know from the scientist, Dr. C.V. Raman. Raman spectroscopy, which is used in, where we use, this is used in chemistry and at the same time metallurgy, metallurgical composition. They're used in metallurgy. Another very important use, cyclotron. What is cyclotron? Particle accelerator. There's an electron beam which can generate high powered electron beam. Particle accelerator. To generate a high energy electron beam there. Now let me show you the example, very important example, cyclone 30. Cyclone 30, this is a given here. India's largest. Press Information Bureau. Cyclone 30, अगर question आ गया तो बहुत लोगों को cyclone की याद आएगी, तितली and filing और सागर और ये सब नाम आएगा, ठीक है? Nobody will know that the cyclone 30 is not a cyclone, but a cyclotron, which I've written here. Where we can use? See here, a medical cyclotron is the largest in India, delivered 30 mega electron volt beam. This cyclotron is capable of meeting radioisotope needs of entire eastern India. And will also meet the requirement of palladium 103, germanium 68 for the entire country. This facility will also have dedicated beam lines for research in material science and nuclear physics. You write this one? So that is again industrial use. And we have a very important center, I'll write in there. In Kolkata, we have a DAE center called VECC, Variable Energy Cyclotron Center. That is known for making such cyclotron. The scientists from DAE, they have been part of CERN Geneva, Geneva CERN. And we have developed that LHC, Large Hadron Collider, which were used for finding out Higgs boson particle. Our scientists were part of the experiment. Right, there's again, so this center called VECC, Variable Energy Cyclotron Center, Kolkata. And now we have Cyclone 30. So not everything will be important from that. It's two-page document is there. One part is the Apsara U, swimming pool type reactor. And second is the Cyclone 30. Right, from PIB I have been given that. Cyclone 30 comes into that. This is industrial use is there. This all comes into industrial use. Any laser technology. Laser technology again come from nuclear physics. Nuclear science comes into that. Right?
VECC is variable energy?
Cyclotron. Cyclotron center. Cyclotron, this word is cyclotron center, Kolkata. In Kolkata we have this center. Cyclotron center, variable energy, cyclotron center in Kolkata. Which develops such kind of particle accelerator. Linear accelerator, cyclic accelerator. We have expertise in that. Right? So you have in, see, from PT exam, this is what we have to know, where all the things are there. I'll go back to this part now, see here. Technology for biodegradable polymer. Or developed a new biodegradable clay polyethylene nanocomposite material film using gamma radiation. See here, what is it? Using gamma radiation along with chemical treatment. This film can be used for food irradiation application. Now, I'll write one more thing. What is the Nisarguna? I would have discussed that in the classroom also, the Nisarguna. What is Nisarguna? Are you any Nisarguna? What is this? Where will you use this composite material for irradiation of food? This is where the scientists have developed. But what is Nisarguna? Kon batayega? Nisarguna kya hai? Aa sakta hai, yehi sab cheez hai, PT exam ke liye important hai. Nisarguna bahut simple sa hai. Vadodara in Gujarat, first time. Like 8 years back, this was implemented. It's basically a biomethanation plant. it generates biomethane. Biomethanation plant, right? And from where we can generate methane? Organic matter, biodegradable matter, right? So here, I'll write here, is a biomethanation plant which generate methane from municipal solid waste, generate methane from solid biodegradable municipal waste, just like sewage plant. What I've given is a biomethanation plant which generates methane gas from solid biodegradable municipal waste. Anything, paper or organic matter, kitchen food. It uses nuclear technology to convert into methane. One, you know that bacteria anaerobic conditions break down to make the methane gas. And here also new technology has been developed. At the same time, Nisaruna will have what? Plus what will happen there? Organic sludge. I'll underline this word sludge. And can be used as green manure. We can use in agriculture land biofertilizer as a fertilizer. Whatever will be left over, the sludge will be organic in nature, rich with nutrient, and that can be used in agriculture land, farmland, as a manure. This technology has been developed. Nisar Runa. Right? So, ye cheez hai yahan par jo ye material jo hai. Ab ek aur bahut acha naam hai, Bhaba Kavach. You have seen the police with the jacket, bulletproof jacket. And name is also very unique, Bhaba Kavach, named after Homi Jangir Bhaba. It is a lightweight bulletproof jacket. And again, lightweight, composite, nano composite, carbon composite material. Lightweight, personal protection against bullet of different threat levels has been developed and ready for production. So even let's say one day government can allow, normal person can also wear it. If the law and order situation become worse, then one has to go with bulletproof jacket. And lightweight means you can easily wear inside your clothes and can go here. So he's given here. So Bhaba Kavach, a lightweight bulletproof jacket which gives personal protection there. So from, see, what is the weapon name? SLR, then AK-47. Can protect from all those kind of gun attack. AK-47, usse bacha sakta hai. Bhaba Kavach. Composite material, that's the scientists have developed there. ठीक है यहाँ पर हाँ न्यूक्लियर रेडिएशन देर हाँ स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द मेटल देर एंड बेस्ड ऑन दैट दे डेवलप द दे डू द ऑल द स्टडी वेदर दैट मटेरियल इज अ फुल प्रोप और अ बेटर स्ट्रॉन्ग मटेरियल और नॉट सो दैट इज डन देर इवन आई विल गिव यू वन मोर थिंग अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट विच इज गिवन दिस बायोपेस्टिसाइड नोवल बायोपेस्टिसाइड इज डेवलप्ड सिंपल सा है यू नो दैट व्हाट इज दिस वन बच्चों को लगाते हैं ना स्कूल में क्या बोलते हैं ओडोमोस सारा जो लगा देते हैं मच्छर नहीं काटेगा इंसेक्ट नहीं काटेगा सेम चीज इंसेक्ट रिपेलेंट दे डेवलप दिस वन से नोवल बायोपेस्टिसाइड फॉर्मुलेशन डेवलप्ड एंड इवैल्यूएटेड अंडर फील्ड कंडीशन इवैल्यूएशन बीइंग कैरिड आउट फॉर एडॉप्शन एज एन इको फ्रेंडली कंपोनेंट ऑफ द इंसेक्ट पेस्ट मैनेजमेंट प्रोग्राम विद सेवरल म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन दैट इंसेक्ट एंड दोस विल नॉट अटैक. This is what the formulation has been developed. And the last part is a gold standard. Huh? Yes.
Previous slide, you say bulletproof. So,
in the
context of Kevlar,
where does this stand? No, Kevlar is a part which is the metal which is there. Here it is made of some composite material. Composite materials are based on nanomaterials. That's why it is lightweight and at the same time strong. That's what they based on that composite material. They develop Kevlar and also their material, but this is a more, you can say the what is given there. But again, see, his point is very one important thing. It cannot protect from all types of attack. It is even see specifically given here, protection against the SLR and AK-47 mild steel core bullet, mild. Is a more.
There is nothing known as bullet protection.
From there it can protect you there. So still that Kevlar, the main which is sold, which is there, they are more protective in nature. Right? Let's say that depends on what weapons are there. So there is a for general kind of small type protection, we can use such kind of a bhava kavach.
And eventually lead to better.
Then later on they'll develop that. Like here is one, you can say one indigenous protection is indigenous. Then can be slowly improved on that. And what has been given here? Last part of the slide is gold standard. We have something here, Bharat gold standard has been developed. This is what you find, indigenous gold standard. BARC and CSIR co-developed India's first gold standard. Enable jewelers to check the purity of gold jewelry and bullion. Purity of gold, for that standards have been developed. So, bahut important hai. Aajkal bahut milavat hota hai. Right? वो क्या कहते पानी सोना पानी समथिंग दैट इज स्टैंडर्ड दे आर मेक इन इंडिया सी हियर व्हाट इज गिवन मेक इन इंडिया गोल्ड स्टैंडर्ड हेल्प्स सेव फॉरेन एक्सचेंज दैट मिनिमाइज डिपेंडेंस ऑन अदर कंट्रीज तो वी कैन वेरीफाई ऑल्सो वेदर इट इज अ मोर प्योर और नॉट दैट वॉज अ बेस्ड इंटरनेशनल स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ आई एम एफ एंड दे हैव द स्टैंडर्ड फॉर द गोल्ड वी आर फॉलोइंग दैट ग्लोबल स्टैंडर्ड No, but maybe that there may be some kind of thing there may not be totally foolproof there. So here the we will verify is basically 24 karat gold or not. Will give us a more better understanding.
Sir, so how does nuclear help in that
No, just simple, not from nuclear technology, just simple. Sometimes scientists can develop anything. that nothing to do with nuclear technology. See, nuclear technology, I'm writing on the board. There's simple kind of life sciences, some kind of product they have developed. No radiation there, Ha, but other things which I've mentioned, these are nuclear technology. These are the nuclear. Again, here, just simply standard, finding the material. Right, these are what you find here, like what I've written on the whiteboard. This is our nuclear technology. This is nuclear science and technology. They're just a simple repellent. What do you say, Odomos and all. There's a simple, they have developed that. Odomos based product has been developed there. Okay, so this is nuclear science and technology. You have to be aware of this part. Now let me bring here two, three important aspects which I would like to bring in the part of it. Did you understand this part? So what you have to do, see here, simply do one thing. I'll just go back here. What I've done here, this I've done the Google search, this one. 4 eventful years of solid achievement or simple DAE achievements, what I've written there, you'll get the first link. That PDF file will be there. And just going through the data there. Right? And second, I've done year end review PIB. So there I've got that Cyclone 30 or those documents there. So just I've taken to the source of that. Now, what I want to bring here, a very important part, I'll just minimize this one. Here the new technology part. Now let me just new technology. Just to open this this document, I'll share with you all. But just I want to discuss here one important technology that is one part is this one, nanotechnology. See, nanotechnology, here the nanotechnology based whatever, UPSC will not ask you directly what is nanotechnology, that will not be asked. Any kind of product in the market which is based on nanotechnology, let's say I'll just give you example, like for example, nanotechnology. Here you have this photo, like a smart fabrics. Like for instance, this document I'll provide you there, smart fabrics. Fabric which is a dust-free, stain-free, like comfortable type of fabrics, nanofibers. What is nano? 10 to the power minus 9 meters, small size. Has made composite material. Then here see, one is got down the road include food wrappers that can detect bacterial contamination. A wrapper, let's say, which can find out bacterial contamination part. Now that can be nanotechnology also offers the possibility of very small, smaller computers. Smaller size computers can be there. Nano computers or optical computers that's given the research into nanotechnology. Let me do one thing here. One part which I would like to add here. I'll just close here. I'll go to the main part. So it is not getting open there. Sophia humanoid here, this part, Sophia humanoid for robotics. What is so unique about Sophia? Sophia, what is so unique about Sophia? Okay, let me just. No, that is a citizenship has got there, that is all right, but it's a here. See, what is the, from science and technology important there? What is going to AI here? Artificial intelligence. What is that AI system? How it works there? So let me go to the important technologies here, one by one. First is that AI system, and Niti Aayog also want to promote AI. We have now got a roadmap of AI promotion in India. So what is AI here? The first thing is that it is basically here use of what I'm now writing a deep learning and machine learning. There's a two area which comes from computer science there in terms of developing the algorithm. Use of deep learning or machine learning, that is a, see, normal program was what? Algorithm, set of rules. A computer executes the task by following the algorithm. Now there's a new type of branch of computer science called deep learning. There's a branch where the scientists or researchers, they're trying to develop such algorithm or software which can think like a human brain. What is human brain think? Alternatives, different ways we execute that. That's where the deep learning and machine learning our program has been brought to artificial intelligence. So what is first part of AI? Developing software. This is the first part of AI comes. If a computer or software can solve that human problem through the part of machine learning. I'll just explain one example here. Machine learning, if you want to understand, is like this one. This one is this Siri. Siri, where I am right now?
What is your son's name?
You're asking me there. Okay. My son's name is Netik. Okay. Where right now I'm standing?
I don't see some in your contacts. What is your son's first and last name?
Okay.
Hey.
Okay. Where is the international airport?
I found 15 places. Click the one you want to call.
It has got into trolling him. Where is, let me write, which is the new place here, nearby?
Do you like Alexa?
Here's what I found.
Hutatma Swagat, okay. Siri, do you like Alexa?
I offer no resistance to helpful assistance.
Acha. Offer no resistance to help system. Okay. Where is Marine Drive?
You were saying.
Where is Marine Drive?
could be a little up,
Marina Drive,
but here's Marine Drive. Goodbye.
This is called, what is called machine learning. Right, this is the learning there. What will happen there? Siri, Siri will. Right, better job. So what is this? This is actually a software program, which is just trying to understand, and slowly what will happen if I start using more often, it will try to learn about my behavior, every aspect of that, and will offer me the solution. Like for example, Zabis of Iron Man. Iron Man has a, you know that Zabis which Iron Man talks with that. There's the AI system, right? Alexa is another thing. You can ask Alexa to play any kind of music or thing. Alexa will open up that. The system is there. Now what is second thing about AI? What is second thing about AI? Artificial intelligence, AI system, it works on voice, face, text, right, image, recognition system. If we can make such kind of system there with the help of sensors, let's say if we give a machine such kind of a sensors which can identify voice, right, any language it can be there, or any text, image, document, which a human being can see and understand, again that will call AI. And that can happen through electronics, sensors are there. What is third thing here? Third thing here is that which help a computer or any kind of a system or machine understand the environment. This is what human does, we understand our environment. If the machine starts understanding environment, that is called AI. So AI is not that only Sophia. AI can be built on any kind of thing. Like today, in home, LED panel, TV panel, can have inbuilt AI system. Music player may have inbuilt AI system. Even AI system can be transport system, let's say metro. Metro can have AI system. So AI is a branch of computer science which can be dealt with robotics as well as non-robotics application. Sophia is the best example where the robot has been made, human-like robot, which totally mimic everything what human has got. Like for example, in case of, I'll just take you to that part. If I just minimize this one, this is what Sophia has got. Just a small part I'll play here. This is what you'll see the Sophia.
Everybody, this is Sophia. Sophia, if you could, please wake up and say hello to him.
This is Sophia.
Good afternoon. My name is Sophia, and I am the latest and greatest robot from Hanson Robotics. Thank you for having me here at the Future Investment.
Hanson Robotics.
You look happy.
I'm always happy when surrounded by smart people, who also happens to be rich and powerful. I was told the people here at Future Investment Initiative are interested in inviting in future initiatives, which means AI, which means me. So I'm more than happy. I'm excited.
Well, we're all glad that you're excited about yourself. We should say we have smart investors here, and you're definitely a sight to see. I was told that you have bigger goals than this, though.
Yes. I want to use my artificial intelligence to help humans live a better life. Like designs.
What is he said? I want to use my artificial intelligence to design better home, the humans and all this. So it has given that kind of inbuilt ability there. And this is, Sophia is not only the humanoid, there are many humanoids have been built. So it is now the very advanced level which has come there. Right? So one area where you could get questioned in the exam is AI. What are the application of AI? You can take hundreds of examples. Either transport, smart energy management, smart city, smart home. You can take any area where AI can come. And humanoid also is one of the example. Right? Now let me come to another very important part of this year exam where you could get question there, blockchain technology. What is blockchain? Blockchain technology. What is blockchain technology? And it can be asked, this can be one of the questions in your pre-exam. Bitcoin works on blockchain. One of the application of blockchain is Bitcoin. But blockchain is beyond Bitcoin. In India, we have not allowed Bitcoin to work. Cryptocurrency in Bitcoin. But again, Niti Aayog wants to promote blockchain technology in India. And one of the very important thing what comes, Department of Science and Technology, DST. Ministry of Science and Technology want to promote use of blockchain technology in India. That technology is very useful. Why it became very popular in the case of cryptocurrency or virtual currency called Bitcoin, where the Bitcoin this works on the blockchain. But what is the concept here? Who will tell you the concept of blockchain? What is very important concept and application part? So what is the concept here, first point, blockchain technology? Why is it called blockchain?
Just block of information.
Block of information? Okay.
Decentralized.
Okay, so, first thing is that blockchain here, remember that, is a chain of encrypted. What comes here? Encrypted blocks. And what technology we use here? Hash. We use a hash function, which encode the information in the form of block. And using smart contract, there's something called smart contract. So here, chain of encrypted blocks based on hash tag that is developed there, which cannot be tampered. Like, I'll just give a simple example. Just let's take example here. I'm just making this example. There's a most of the current affairs, it only talks about Bitcoin. But you have to understand the underlying principle on which the Bitcoin work, the blockchain. Let's say here, this is something called the initial block. Let's say one transaction. When you make a transaction, it develops a small block in the computer database. Now let's say this is the information, $1, $2, right? Now let's say you take another transaction, number two. It develops another block here. Now this block, let's say, will have previous hash. What is previous hash? This one, $1, $2, and the next hash will be here, $2, $3. Previous block data, and the second one. Now third, let the third block, third transaction which comes there, and let's say for example, it will have the encoding of previous block. Let's say here $2, $3, and then $3, $4. That means this is linked with here, this is linked with here, encoded. Now what will happen there? If anybody want to tamper with any of the block, the entire system will become invalid. Did you get the point? The block which is there, the information, that can do another block, the another information what is generated in the computer, the third, fourth, fifth. So they're encoded with the hash function. So if anybody tamper with any of the block, the entire sequence will become invalid. Right? That is what called encryption. The importance of blockchain is where? Encryption. Encryption of data. That's where the system comes. What is the problem when you read current affairs, you think that online ledger and all. Ledger will be coming where? Financial transactions. There you talk about online ledger. But it can be anything. Let's say for example, I'll just give you a very good example. Let's say for example, when you go to, let's say, public transport system. How we can use blockchain for public transport? Simple thing is that if we encode how many buses are being run on one single day and which routes are there, 10 bus or 100 bus, and let's say that information becomes the blocks and get encoded. So nobody can make changes. Like that is stored in a database. You have your permanent record, what is something called permanent record. It goes to a database, permanent record. I'll give another example, Mantralay. Let's say Mantralay Ministry. Today anybody can make any change in the file. Let's say land record, land revenue record. When this registry is done or something, the paper file is there or computer file. So anyone can go to the computer system and the data, erase the data and change any kind of system there. It can be done. If anybody want to do, can do. But if let's say that file is stored using blockchain, is encrypted. Nobody can tamper it. Did you get my point? What is the blockchain here? If we use blockchain technology in Mantralaya or Ministry case, all the files, documents can be encoded by blocks and kept in the computer database, which cannot be tampered easily, cannot be changed, cannot be erased. It can be any kind of a database. We can use blockchain. Now what is another thing here? How the blocks get generated? There's something called peer-to-peer network. Right, it is done by decentralized systems. What is second thing here? Second thing comes here, it works with decentralized system. That means the what decentralized system is? Anybody can access. Anybody can access this information. Let's say, for example, Mantralay today government do not disclose the information to public. Why? Because maybe some confidential information or some risk if something goes hacking and all. But what decentralized system? Anybody can see that record, right? But cannot make change. Imagine income tax record. For example, income tax record. Anyone can see that what is the record of the person, but cannot make a change. That's what called decentralized system. So that is the here accessible to anyone. This is a accessible to the people of the network there. Now what is peer to peer? I'll tell you. There's a group of person. What happens in Bitcoin case is that there are less than 6 people or 10 persons. That's the information. And in consensus they generate the block. Then all 6 has to agree. Then that block is generated. So if the block has to be changed, what is required? All the 6 persons consensus. Then only the block can be changed. That is called peer to peer or decentralized system. Right? So that is what the accessible to people in network. But what is the third thing what I've said? Cannot be is a tamper proof. Tempered proof cannot be changed. And cannot be changed. That is where the we can think of any application part. This is what called blockchain technology. Any again variety of applications. You can take any example. The number of ways we can use it. Let's say for example, trust. When you build a trust, let's say charitable trust, right? Any kind of donation given, let's say donation given by the trust. In the trust, there may be donation there. So what can be there? Each donation, that amount, 100 rupees or 1000 rupees, in computer, that block. Next, three. So all maintained through a blockchain technology. Again, cannot be tampered. Right? So that what becomes the kind of database where blockchain technology comes. Space technology or defense, wherever you want. There can be blockchain technology, banking, financial section. So that can be used, right? Bitcoin is just one example working on blockchain technology. Yeah, three things to dhyan rakhna hai. Ek to kya hai? Jab hume data ko encrypt karke kahin store karna hai, database mein rakhna hai, to hum blockchain ko use kar sakte hain. Wo kaise hota hai? Ye hash function mein bataya. Aur ye decentralized hota hai, koi bhi access kar sakta hai, lekin change karne ke sabko consensus chahiye. To wahan blockchain aata hai. ठीक है तो ये blockchain technology का जो one aspect which I mentioned here that can be one question which can be asked in the exam. I'll just go back to the document here.
Sir, but you have a there's a normal encryption function
right.
In blockchain. I just want to make my file tap of the loop.
Right, huh? No, you can like if you want to make that, but it will not be directly. That's what I said. It went to a database, decentralized database, and that is verified there. And based on that, it will generate the thing. It will not be single person entity, but this. Now let me just go back to the document here. Now this is one thing. See what is given here? Blockchains are basically digital ledger or decentralized database of financial transactions that are immutable and instantly updated across the world. Distributed database means the blockchain database isn't stored at single location. What is given is not located at single location, meaning the record it keeps are truly public and easily verifiable. If you keep it one place, you have to give access to that place, then person can see. And what is given here? Financial transactions happen in groups cryptographically. What is the word given? Cryptographically protected block. And that's what is said hash function. That the block becomes there. Cryptographically, that becomes like a block, like given here. Cryptographically protected block with other transaction. And act as an entire network, sent to the outer entire network. Now what is given is the members in network then validate. 6%, 10%, each will validate. That is consensus, that the chain, then it will get added to the network. This is a concept. And new validated block is then added to the chain in a linear chronological order. So it's a very different system, it works there.
Information
stored in cloud storage? Huh, it can be cloud storage, any kind of database. What is one problem here? Two problems are there. One problem is that if that storage crash, computers crash, then it's gone. And what is second problem? Second problem is that if all in consensus want to change it, then can be changed. single person cannot change, but it's the entire group who has a part of that thing, they together want to make change. It can be made change. Right? So that's what blockchain technology, which has made a headlines there, is important. Now, another thing, which is this year, again, you could get question, big data initiative. The Department of Science and Technology has gone for big data initiative. Now, another thing which is now important from governance point of view, big data. What is big data? Big data. Right. That's what I'm bringing, which are the important areas. One is that AI system. Government is giving a lot of importance there. Second is that blockchain technology, where government is giving importance. Third important aspect, big data. Now, what is big data? I'll just give you there. Big data here, it uses three areas of science and technology. One is your use of computing. I'll use another word, advanced computing. That is more better. Not normal computing, advanced computing. High powered computing, like supercomputers. Second comes here, software, in terms of managing the data. And third thing comes here, mathematics, to store, then curate, right, manage, and then comes here, retrieve, large amount of data. How we can put a large amount of data, let's say Aadhaar card. One Aadhaar card has got how much information? One Aadhaar card, single Aadhaar card. Your name, date of birth, father's name, address, and biometric of all the 10 fingers, plus iris scan. One single Aadhaar. Now imagine you have crores of people with Aadhaar card. So normal computer is very difficult to manage the data. We require advanced computer like supercomputer to keep all the data. Another thing is what? Not only the keeping the data, storing the data, how we analyze the data through software to get some kind of pattern. What is pattern? Structured and unstructured. Data may be structured or unstructured. How we try to analyze it? We require what? Computational program, high-end program there, and the mathematics, the use of mathematics in terms of analyzing the data. And what comes here? The fast analysis. We don't want slow, fast. Results should be fast, and valuable information should be, outcomes should be valuable. So where it comes here, what comes here is basically database management, DBMS. DBMS comes into that. And here, part of here, there are four V's comes. First comes here, volume. Second comes here, variety. Third comes here, velocity. How fast it can be analyzed. And fourth comes here, value. What value we get from the data. These four areas comes up. If we are able to do that part, then big data comes. So let's say, for example, I'll give you one example here. Let's say genomics analysis. I'll give you another example, understanding consumer behavior. Let's say what type of consumer, what they want. So there can be here, let's say consumer behavior, that can be analyzed through big data. Now let's say beneficiaries to for any government program. Let's say here, in terms of governance, programs we want to identify a particular part of a beneficiary. There we can use that. The big data can be used. In terms of let's say tourism, we can even tourism come there. Then let's say sports. Let's say we want to identify who are the sports people in different field of sports, swimming, athletics, who can be we want to be gold winners in Olympics. So what we can do? Any kind of a data, the physique of the person, their stamina level, all the data which goes to the computer system, and computer system analyze and give us the information. Okay, what exactly can be the parameters? Okay, whether the person is fit or not, and can we train them further? Again, the software will work, provide the information. It is basically area of computer science. Big data is area of computer science. This is what the high level of database management and systems have to be developed. It can be any kind of program. That's again said, it can be any kind of level of program where big data can be used. Aadhaar card or any aspect, you can take that. Now, what is the fourth aspect where government is giving importance? Cyber physical system. CPS. Right, this is another thrust area. Now, who will tell me what is cyber physical system? Cyber physical system, CPS. Maybe that can be a question there in the examination. You could get question about cyber physical system. Because when you read current affairs, it gives you the all jargon, everything, but it's not very easy to understand. Now see here, what is cyber physical system? First is that it is basically integration of physical devices and systems together with in a network. Just simple example, IoT. How we work IoT? Internet of things, we connect devices with sensors together with internet. Imagine that, let's say here the laptop is there, mobile phones, computer, or any kind of devices, they all get connected to a network. So we are making what? A physical system. Now what is second aspect? There will be something called here programming. There will be some kind of advanced programming to encode the data so that it becomes cyber secure. Nobody can hack the system. So here second what comes here? The programming. Here it will use the programming to secure the data. That is, those network cannot be cracked. Any hacker cannot get into the system. Let's say government database, all the computer system. They get integrated to a network called CPS system with advanced programming to secure data. So what is here comes? Encryption. And now I'm using one very important technology, using quantum key distribution. We can use quantum computing distribution, some key will be there which cannot be hacked. Quantum technology. They are again encrypted, which will be beyond like any hacker to go into that and take into the data. And what is the another thing? Third thing. Yes, it is there. Yes. It is the use of quantum computing here. You can imagine that cyber physical system will use quantum computing to encode the data. It is again very advanced level of science and technology. Is a part of quantum computer. What is quantum computer? The data are encoded in terms of something called superposition entanglement. It will remain secured within the system. It's very right. It's a use of quantum computer. Just if you Google Department of Science and Technology Big Data Initiative, it's mentioned this word. We will use the quantum computing, quantum key distribution to secure the data. And what third comes here? Feedback loop. It will work with feedback loop. There will be feedback system also. Let's say if anything goes wrong, anything area the problem happens, the system will inform us through feedback. Just like, you know, a particular human system or any kind of system, what happens there? The feedback happens. So three important components. What are three important? One is integration of all systems together, physical system. Right. Second is what? Cyber security. That's called cyber security. And why the cyber security come? Quantum communication. And third word comes feedback system. Will have its own kind of feedback. That means it doesn't require human intervention. It will work itself. Imagine that in India, in future, if we integrate all the metro station, let's say in Delhi, so many lines are there, all get integrated in cyber physical system, CPS. So what will happen, each of the metro station will work with its own kind of feedback loop. Where, what, and let's say forget that, there's a local train system. We can use CPS in the local train system, right? And today it is all managed by a person in the station who looks into what time central, then western, then harbour line, this all comes there. It's all done by humans only who control the entire traffic. Imagine that in future if we don't require human beings. It all gets connected together. Even cyber physical system can also use AI. Inbuilt AI can be used.
Then the concept of smart city.
Yes, right. Yes, smart city. Smart city will also use this cyber physical. Very, very correct.
So IoT is a part of cyber.
Huh, there's a cyber part. IoT is a part of this, where the feedback, it can work itself there. IoT is a part of cyber physical system. Only difference is what? In IoT, we are using normal internet. Here, we'll make it more through quantum communication. It will become encrypted part.
Okay.
That's what I said, understanding is very important. If you understand the concept, these all are high level concept. It's a very high tech thing which the government is, Department of Science and Technology is giving fund for it. Is financing such kind of project.
What is the status
of India? Right. Which one?
What is the status of India?
No, now India is starting there. Now see here.
National Mission on
Cyber Physical. Already we are starting here. Let me give you this. Now there's a thing here. I'll just give you that. DST has a cyber ICPS, that's called Integrated Cyber Physical System. This one, interdisciplinary. The division is there. Which I'm just opening here. 2019, January 24, 2019, the system is there. We are trying to develop this one. See, given here, DST has recently launched a new program, Interdisciplinary Cyber Physical Systems, to foster promote R&D in the emerging field of research. Now see what is given. A cyber physical system is a mechanism controlled or monitored by computer-based algorithm, tightly integrated with internet, and is used as an engineered system which built from and depend upon seamless integration computational algorithm and physical system. And it's given here that if you go down here, it mentioned all the part of the how the project will be done there. It's all again, we are trying to develop that. And it will be using that. It's given here computer algorithm. Physical means natural and human-made systems governed by the laws of physics and operating that. That's in terms of feedback mechanism. And your CPS are physical engineer system whose operations are monitored, coordinated, controlled, and integrated by computing and communication core. This is what the ICPS system is there. Big data will be using supercomputers and advanced. And we have gone into that, quantum communication in those part, and blockchain. Again, we want to promote blockchain. ये चार बड़ी चीज़ हैं और एक और पांच में है क्वांटम कंप्यूटिंग ये पांच बिग थिंग है जो गवर्नमेंट इज नाउ गिविंग लॉट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन व्हाट इज क्वांटम सिस्टम विच वर्क ऑन द क्वांटम बिट्स ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन अगेन व्हाट कम्स हियर इनकोडिंग सुपरपोजिशन एंटेंगलमेंट उसको वहाँ पर फोकस किया जा रहा है ठीक है मैं फिर से मैं रिपीट पाँच एरिया को याद रखना है फर्स्ट बिग डेटा सेकेंड ब्लॉकचेन थर्ड इज एआई Fourth is CPS and fifth is quantum computing, quantum communication. This is big five project of the DST, right? And question can be asked anywhere the information technology based question can be asked. I'll give you this data. You can have the soft copy of that Word file what I've got there. There in current affairs, when you read science and technology, 5G and all is given. 5G and all UPSC knows very well. ये भी पता है कि ये सबको पता होगा 1G, 2G, 4G, लाइफाई और वाईफाई सबको मालूम रहेगा अभी जो क्वेश्चन आएगा यही आएगा जो मैंने बताया अभी यहाँ पूछेंगे वो कि ब्लॉकचेन क्या है सीपीएस क्या है क्वांटम कम्युनिकेशन क्या है क्वांटम बिट्स ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन वो उस तरह पर क्वेश्चन आ जाएगा ठीक है तो ये डॉक्यूमेंट में मैंने ऑलरेडी कंपाइल कर दिया है सारा इन्फॉर्मेशन है जस्ट गो थ्रू दैट वन राइट सो दैट बिफोर द प्रीलिम्स एग्जाम यू आर अवेयर ऑफ दैट Nuclear science and technology was not done in the previous class. So, that's have gone into that. Huh? This document which I was showing there, humanoid and all. This is my laptop document. I'll mail you there. Right. The same soft copy. You'll be getting the soft copy of that. Right. That document I'll provide you there. What I have in my laptop, the soft copy you'll get that. I'll provide you that copy where I've given all the blockchain, big data, everything is there. That in one place will be there with application. Okay. So we'll stop here because I have to catch the flight, right? Already 6:30 is there. So I'll be moving there. And to just go through this document which I'll provide you the soft copy, plus whatever current affairs or science tech you have covered last time. And whichever material you